Hello and welcome back to another Cmdr Embryo stream. Today we've got a quick special lunchtime stream, and I'm going to get myself over to Founder's World, pick up a vulture. Whoa there! Whoa! No! Mute. Classic embryo styley. Right. Yeah. So we're going to head over to Founder's World. Pick up a vulture so I can continue my 1 hour bounty hunting challenge, and I'll probably end up choosing a sort of similar build to the vulture setup that I've got on my YouTube channel, so we'll see how it still fares, because that's quite an old video now, so I might need to update that at some point. Okay, so we're gonna plot our course. We're gonna change ships. So I'm going to jump into my Anaconda, because it's got a way better jump range. Actually saying that though, this one's... No, we'll do the Anaconda, yep. Yeah, so we're going to quickly head over to Founder's World, pick up the vulture. I find it easier, let alone the 10% saving, but I find it a shed ton easier than going anywhere else to buy stuff, because all the modules, you know what I mean, you can just get what you need. Come on, servers, do your thing. How's the stream looking? Getting some oddball bit rates going on here. Doesn't look too bad. Oh yeah, right, we'll stabilised a bit. Right. Okay, so, sorry about that. So 160 light years, probably about 5 or 6 jumps. The Conda. Oh, that's good. We can get there in one go as well. We don't even have to scoop. This won't show up on the archive, but I'm just going to stop the stream because I'm getting some wildly fluctuating bit rates here. But I'll keep an eye on it for the moment. Whoa there. I don't think I could leave without smacking my head on it. So the trip there is not the bad one. It's the trip back. Right, quick drink of water, sort that cough out. Hello there, Aussie, how you doing, buddy? Cheers for popping in. 3, 2, 1. How you doing, buddy? Thank you. You have to let us know, Ozzy, if you're in for a little, for a few moments, mate. Let us know how the stream's doing, because I'm getting some wildly fluctuating bit rates showing up on OBS here. However, my sort of preview screen looks to be not too bad. Right, I don't need one, but I'm going to make one. You know what it'll be. Right. Okay, so we're now on our way to Shinrata to pick up the our vulture. I'd like to liquidate a whole pile of ships when
fuel scoop disengaged.
Lost my train of thought. When I bought the Corvette, and unfortunately my vulture was one of them. So now I'm going to pick up another little Hornet. My next bounty hunting challenge. So it'll be a nice little test. As far as possible, I'm going to try and get the build that I've currently got as my vulture ship build on my YouTube channel. But that video now is pretty old. That was pre 1.4, I think, if not earlier. So it'll be interesting to see how it still fares and whether or not it's still a relevant build. But it won't be, it's not the trip there that's the trouble, it's the trip back with these combat ships. Whatever combat ship you're gonna get, they're almost without fail, their downfall is their jump range. I mean, any commander with an FDL knows that, you know, 13, 14 light years, I think maybe you can push 15 out of it, possibly, I haven't tried. But it's a little bit of a slog if you're trying to meet up with people or get to a community goal that's on the other side of the bubble. You know, compared to ships like the Asp or the Anaconda.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
You know, if you go in with that in mind, then you're aware of its downfall. Well, not downfall, its downside. You can learn to live with it. There you go, nice easy trip.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Just taking it easy this lunchtime, you see, I might pick up a bit of combat on the way back with the vulture, you know, test it out a little bit, see if it's still, as I said, a viable build. But it's probably a nice little chill stream for you guys having your lunches, if you're in the UK, that is. Oh, we're just going to come into Founder's World now. Right. Jameson Memorial targeted.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
The large jump range ships don't often make the bubble seem a small place. I remember way back when, get in that Sidewinder with a, what's it, 7 light-year jump range or something, and you think, oh. Even like when I first started, 30 light years was, oh, blimey, 4 jumps, blimey. Do that in a blink of an eye now. Commander Flint, how you doing, buddy? Nice to see you, mate. Cheers for popping in. Hope all is well with you. Getting down with the blues at lunchtime. I don't know why I'm doing this, so I know I'm going to take it easy, but let's take it easy and let's go in reverse. Working hard, good, glad to hear it, mate. Apologies for the exposure on the camera, it's wildly different lighting conditions on a second by second basis out in my hut here. So, yeah, I think I didn't know. Did you? You tweeted that, didn't you? I thought, well, they've been divisioning it up, and now I'm pretty sure I've seen some of your tweets there, mate. I understand, you know, about the elite. It's sometimes difficult to motivate yourself to. You know, to give yourself your next goal or whatever. It's been nice. I've had some comments on my channel that, you know, people seeing what I've been doing and that's inspired them to do something different or, you know, a similar sort of thing in their games. Oh, you finished Division. Fair play, mate. You're not going long haul for the multiplayer and all that, you know. Robert, were you top dog already? Bit nippy on the buzzer there. Fair enough. Is the music level really quiet on the stream? It's really difficult for me to tell because I haven't got a professional setup. I don't want to wait in a queue, thank you very much. Can we just go? Oh, I get it, yeah. No, no, just keep going. Don't pretend you're in a queue now, right? Let's help you on your way, shall we? There you go. Right. I'm in docking computer, it's way too polite. Good news, fantastic. Cheers. Cheers, Commander. Thanks, mate.
Docking successful. Engines disengaged.
Okay then, let's get purchasing. I'll try and do it from memory as best as possible. I'll try and match my old build. Purchase. I'm gonna do a new ship. I'm not handing my old one in. As always, apologies for the croaky voice. Too many of these. Cloud. Right. Did we win the war? We've expanded into, I think there's three systems now. I have to be honest, I've been out exploring for the last few streams and haven't really taken an active interest in the old wolves at the moment. Sorting out my own bits and bobs. Cheers, buddy. I get varying comments. Some people say, oh, it sounds like you're dying. Another person says, I sound like I've got no testicles, or they're, my voice is breaking. Right, let's, I'm going off on a tangent here. Let's get into outfitting. Okay, so we... Yeah, as always, go for what I'm going to go for on the... Here, I'm going to go for my beams. Fixed beams. Yeah, fixed beams for me. Hold on.
Target locked.
Really? Okay, so yeah, fixed C3 beams, both on both sides. I know they heat up like a mother, but I seem to, you know, like that thing. I won't be, as far as I remember, I didn't take shield cells. Probably going to end up regretting, but I just tanked the shields I had. So I'll get a kill warrant scanner, I'll get a C. C grade one of those. And then I think I'll have to work out what we can do with the power, because I know that there's definite power issues. So I'm going to get military hull. Obviously the best power plant, I got no choice over that. I'll leave the thrusters for a sec. Right, best frame shift, I want to get around early pronto. Life support. 7 minutes normally sorts me fine. Yep. Obviously, best power distributor. D grade sensors should be able to get in pretty pronto, yeah, pretty quick. Shield A5. Get that. Now, this is where I... What did I... Get rid of that. That's... Now, did I have shield cells before? If you have shield cells, you definitely need heat sinks nowadays. How's our... So we're still fine for power. Okay, let's chuck on a... shield booster. Sorry, I'm mulling stuff over. It's difficult to vocalise all my thoughts. Do I go for my... Oh, chaff as well. Definitely chaff. Need a chaff, right. Okay, so that's still got several bits to work with here. Need an interdictor at some point. Shield cell, that's gonna totally muller me, innit? That's just too much power to try and sort out, unless I turn them off. I don't like doing the one where you gotta turn your weapon, you know, retract your weapons. Might have to. Right, let's get rid of the discovery scanner, don't need that. Oh, I haven't done thrusters either. That's why I've got more power. I had more power to work with. That's what was confusing me. So I used a sort of tankier build, slower. I used A4 thrusters. D5s, I can't remember. Again, they're poor heat. Oh. This is a real dilemma, I'm not sure. See, I'm over my half. I'm the optimal mass. Yeah, let's go for the D. Okay, so we've still got a hell of a lot of jiggery pokery to do with our things here. I could chuck on some hull. See how much weight that adds. Two tons, not much. I'll get rid of it if it makes this thing too sluggish. I just realised what I forgot. Just realised why I've got all this extra space. A fuel scoop. Right. Chuck the hull on that. That's why I didn't have a shield cell bank. So I might do this one as a. Yeah. I'm gonna stick a fuel scoop on this. I won't have a shield cell. I'm gonna use this as like a quick nippy in. Do as much damage as possible and get out if need be quick, in terms of my sort of 1 hour challenge idea. So what was I after? A fuel scoop. Right. I'm in the size 4 slot, aren't I? Okay, so I think. I think we're there. No, we're not. I didn't put my colour scheme on. Alright. Where's. Yep, still on that nice yellow there. Right. Make it chrome. Nah. Now it's got to be yellow for my little vulture, my Hunter Killer Hornet. Okay, so we got some module jiggery pokery to do now. Okay, so we are at 111%, so I'm gonna have to have something turned off, definitely. Yeah, taxi yellow, that's the one, mate. Okay, so frameshift drive. I don't like turning that off onto a thing, because often you want to get out quick. But we'll do it for the moment. If I can get rid of it later, I will. Fuel scoop, definitely. Cargo hatch, not even needed. Right, so we still haven't scrubbed enough off. So 107, but hold on, how much have I scrubbed off? So it's 2, 4, 5. Oh, I'm gonna do that shield booster. Why isn't it showing at the bottom? It's 107%, isn't it? Yeah. So that's 3. Oh, I've turned it off. That's why. Oh, that's why it doesn't count. So it goes back up to 111. Right. Okay. The shield boost is pretty much redundant, really, isn't it? Sorry, I'm... May as well take the shield booster off. If it's only going to be on priority 2. Oh. Yep, rather than just sitting there staring into space, let's not take it off, let's turn it off. I don't need it on, so let's get rid of it. Right. If I need to rejig about, because of how the game's changed since my since my previous build. Yeah, that's not a bad idea. Oh yeah, no, I didn't want to spend ages doing it, doing all the setting it out. Yeah, that's good. That's a good way to do it. But I'll sort that later. It's just the initial. I don't want that stuff to turn off when I deploy my weapons. But we'll see. What's our rebuy is 1 million, so I can afford to lose a few in testing them. God, it's different being in a... I've been in big ships recently and it's nice to get into something small and nippy. make the jump.
Jump to light speed.
Okay, so we're on our way back. We've got 14 jumps, unfortunately. It's a really fun ship. It's a real flattering ship as well. PvP, it varies, obviously. That's down to the skill of the player, but PvE, it's great. It makes you feel amazing. You're bobbing and weaving. It really does flatters you as a pilot. It's a lovely ship to fly. And I personally, I mean, you know, you saw me there mulling over the power and all that sort of stuff. I like that it's power starved, and you can't just, there isn't the one build, you know, you can, it puts constraints on you, so it forces you to take compromises here, how it suits your play. If you like shield cells, then you'll need to cut back on other things. If you like me, trying to sort of tank it a bit more, then put those bits on. It's, I like where it sort of forces you to compromise. Sitting on this star for a little bit. Oh, it does for me, Flint. The way I, because I take energy weapons, you know what I mean? Fixed beams, they're super power hungry. And like, always hitting that heat. Two pulses, yeah. There's a lot of people have taken the pulse option. It does make a massive difference because obviously they're the most energy efficient energy weapon. Might have to give that a go. You know, I'm happy to try all different things out, and that's what this 1 hour bounty challenge is. Is sort of to, you know, helping sort of clarify and sort out in my head anyway. If I take the sort of similar approach to how I go about hunting in the res site, I should be able to get some sort of benchmark between the different ships. You know, it does fast, nippy, but fragile, you know, meaning that you need to come back for regular repairs or whatever. Is that better than being a tanky build that can sit there for an hour and just take, you know, like the Corvette, apart from when you make a cock up like I did. You know, it's, I want to sort of try and compare and contrast the different builds, and builds within the same ship as well.
Fuel scooping.
That's cool. Do you, you pirate PvP as well, or is it just,
fuel scoop disengaged.
Just the NPCs? Yeah, I'm not slanting either way. I do a hell of a lot of PvE stuff, not hardly any PvP, but I'm not against it, if you know what I mean.
Four, three, two, one, engage.
Cool. You find you get a lot of, but as a proportion of like real players that you try and pirate, how successful are you? Do they sort of enjoy? How many enjoy the role play aspect of someone being a pirate, and then how many just sort of either beg or grovel or just try and run off?
Disengaged.
You never kill the traitor. Fair play. Nice one. Yeah, don't use the words, but yeah, we know what you mean.
Four,
Oh, cheers. Cheers for the host there, Shizzle. Cheers, pal. So you do give, you do scare the, yeah, you do sort of give them the willies, and you take the, you as far as possible, you take their hull down, but do your best not to, you know, not to kill them. Chisel, hello, Commander. Thanks for the host there, pal. It's appreciated. Well, I've just got a quick 2 hour, about hour and a half left, 12 till 2. On a Wednesday, maybe try and make it sort of a regular thing, lunch with Embryo. Fair play. Well done, Flint. You should be commended, mate. It's people like you that make the game more fun. Yeah, it is more fun. It, when people do the piracy thing and play it nicely and... You know, because all you're doing is, as you know, if you kill people, then you're just driving them into private or solo and you're never going to play with them. Yeah, I had the chance today, Shizzle, so I'll be talking to the missus about restructuring some of the things, like hence the short hour stream last night. I might try and do more regular but shorter streams. Yeah, that's cool, yeah. You just... sorry, excuse me. Just be, yeah, being sensible with you. Oh crap, hold on. Just realised where I am. It's me talking to you guys, I totally forgot. Right, good. I didn't check that where we were going was a scoopable star. Right. Ben Tons is 1 minute. That's fair play. Well, you each play your own game, maybe negotiate and stuff like that. I'm hoping just to sort of build up the... trying to show that, you know, open isn't as scary as some people may have been put off by all the rhetoric that's on the forums and on Facebook groups and stuff like that. It isn't as... It's not as scary as it's made out to be. Yes, you will. You may well get ganked or whatever a couple times, but it only makes you a better player, in my mind.
Fuel scooping complete.
You know, look out for the signs.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Yeah, that's the trouble with the Python. You're going to be having, you know, hard work catching up with a lot of the traders, especially now people who have got cutters. They're just going to be, you know, better top speed, and you can't mass lock them either. So, fair play, nailed it. Then, so you just answered. Yeah, the stream will catch up with you, I think. The prospect of like crafting and loot and stuff like that is interesting. If, like, for instance, you could get a super rare, high rated addition to your thrusters or something, allowing you to to have a better top speed than your ship maybe naturally would have. That'd be cool. I have them fairly unique. That's true, Flint. But you'll try the QBO stuff or the other, the ground assaults. Because at a low rank, you get huge rank regression, like, relatively quickly. Fed rank farming, as far as I'm aware, is still a ton, isn't it? Doing all the charity stuff in and around ton, getting the commodities. It's a nice centrally placed spot. Pick up all, just use threads or whatever you use to grab the medical supplies or whatever. Didn't take me long. Yes, yeah, ton. It's on my channel. Just a quick plug there. Yeah, it's on my YouTube channel. Check it out. It's under the hints and tips playlist. What was that, Flint? Sorry, mate. Tim. My only problem is I want to cut my... Reading hard, right. That's fine, mate. Yeah, just go to ton. That's why I do videos, mate. You don't have to read. Just play it.
Fuel scooping.
How are we doing, anyway? How many more jumps? Three more jumps. See, it didn't take that long. We'll go for it. I won't do this as a timed run. I'll do that as one of my...
Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged.
Good to hear it. Thanks, Shazam. Probably bored your socks off, haven't I? Right. Four, three, two, one, engage. So a couple more jumps to Jonai. We'll jump prop into Primitive port. So that if I do get destroyed, I won't get sent back to Shinrata. Cheers for the host, Jimpy. Thanks, mate.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
No, Flint reset his account. Nutter. You lunatic. Alright there, Jimpy, how you doing, mate? Cheers for popping in for lunch.
4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Yeah, it's all semantics, isn't it? Alright, last little hop. Did you manage to do it?
Fuel scoop disengaged.
That's still not bad going, mate. That's pretty good going, bud. Not bad at all. That's just with trading. Yeah. Well, fair play. You're a better man. Well, I suppose I've done a lot of exploration and stuff like that. And that in some people's mind, that's quite boring, but mind-numbing, should we say? But fair play, though, right? Yeah, that last CG was pretty good for me. I think I made about 110 million or something. Plus another 15 for the payout. Right, so we're just going to come into dock. Get our our checkpoint sorted. What's a sarnie? A sandwich. Gotta get yourself a nice sarnie for lunch. Flinth, you've lost me there, mate. I got no idea what you're referencing. Oh dear, I'm understanding what you obviously got some sadistic tendencies. Or is it masochistic? What's the word? Is it masochistic when it's against yourself? That's a pretty good achievement. Yep. All right, Chisel. Cheers for the host, buddy. You take care. I'll catch you tonight. I should be on normal time. Hope you can pop in. So that was a quick little 3/4 hour excursion to Founder's World and a quick ship purchase. Haven't done a manual dock in a while. Too many docking computers on my big ships.
Docking request granted.
It's so nice to fly a ship that's just agile.
Holy fruit salad.
Oh, cheers for the follow on Uncapping Badger. Thanks, mate, much appreciated. Okay, so we've got ourselves checkpointed here now, rather than 160 odd light years back. Gotta go hunt for some food. No worries, buddy. You take care, Flint, right? See you later on, mate. Right. Okay, let's check it out, and so we'll give this a bit of a baptism of fire in the local hazardous res. So say I'm not going to be doing a my bounty hunting challenge with this ship just yet. That'll probably be next Tuesday or another time. There you go, just testing the shields out. Gotta do it every time. Right, that's a nice, that is a beautiful eclipse. Okay, so yeah, we'll head on to this site. So as I said, as far as possible, I tried replicating the old Vulture build that I've got on my YouTube channel. It's a pretty old video now, and I'm unsure how viable it still is. How's this? Oh, lovely. You know it, Jimpy. Oh, running way too hot. you know it, mate. Yeah, my I like just to make sure the shields are on, test them every time I leave. Bit of a nudge, a scrape of paint. So, luckily for me, we're in one of these pitch black resource extraction sites. So I can't tell even when the asteroids have popped in or not. Wonderful. Right. So, we definitely need power to weapons. Who we got? Hopefully I don't crash into a rock. I can't see an absolute thing. lights on. As if... lights on. Oh, come on, voice attack. Do your thing. Lights on.
Lights on.
That's really helped. it's not going to be a ship that kills me. It's going to be a rock. I know it. Okay, let's...
Scan detected.
Oh, wonderful. First thing is a wing of three.
Scan detected.
One of which... It looks like we've got an asp. Is that an anacon? No. Oh, wonderful. So an anaconda. Okay, so who shall I take out first? It's what the two. So we got Carson and we got two asps. Let's get rid of him first. Yeah, it still shreds those hulls pretty good. Except when I'm firing like a fool. Right. So I'm just gonna get some chaff off.
Target destroyed.
A few more pips into engines. Right, so let's get some distance between. Throw another chaff off. Let's get the... him instead.
Scan detected.
Yeah, see, this is where I'm gonna have to do a bit of rejiggery pokery, I think, to well, we'll see how we fare. We're not out of it yet. Right, four pips to shields. Let's get some distance.
Shields offline. Hull integrity compromised. Taking damage.
Okay. Use a bit of asteroid cover and as I crash. Throw out some chaff. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna try and do. Leave just yet. I know I can easily jump out, go back, repair, and but I think shield cells are something I do want to use, I think. I don't even know. I can't remember if I turned them on or off. Let's have a look. Did I get rid of them entirely? Yes. Okay, so we got our shields back on. Let's get back into the fray. Let's get this. Get some weapon energy. Don't forget chaff, Mike. Alright, so we're going to run away again for a little bit.
Shields offline. Taking damage.
Might just try and see if I can get this guy. Take one of them out at least. Module non-function. 62%. 61. Come on. Come on, weapons. Get the flock out of here now. Right, let's... Right. Got a bit of distance between him and us now. Let's... Okay, so we'll get our shields up a little bit. Who's... is it still just him after us? I think it is. Keep forgetting about chaff. Right, let's... can't keep... let's draw him away, draw him away. That's it, mate. Nearly up to full shields again.
Shields online.
Right, fantastic, let's get back in there. Attack pattern beta. Come on, lasers, deploy. I got stuck for some reason. Deploy heatsink. Come on!
Cabin pressure alert. Atmosphere.
I'm not getting much power into anything here, am I? Let's... cut our losses for a little bit.
Cabin pressure alert.
That's a good test. It's certainly holding up. I mean, obviously, I know I'm on 23%. 23%, 21%.
Module malfunction. Power plant capacity exceeded. Thrusters offline.
Come on.
Online.
I think that's time to bug out.
Cabin pressure alert.
So discretion is better part of valor there. I think we'll definitely take a deploy heatsink.
Heatsink deployed.
There you go. Oh, FSD malfunctioned, have we? Oh, you little...
deployed. Target shields online. Cabin pressure alert.
There you go, nice and safe. Okay.
Four, three, two,
so unfortunately it didn't get the wing, but it, obviously it was a bit of a tough ask. Not for a lot of commanders, it's not, but I haven't flown the Vulture for a while, and this particular build was something that was viable prior to like 1.4, I think. So
cabin pressure alert.
I'm quite happy to have that as a test. That was... So a shield cell bank, I think, is...
Cabin pressure alert.
Done my normal trick, not selected where I'm going. Right, is required, I believe. I don't know if Priblov has got anything that will be suitable for me, but unfortunately I'll have to do some proper rejigging of the... unless I have them on priority, effectively priority 2, and I can use the shield cell when I track my weapons.
Retracting weapons.
Don't need to do. Totally forgot about my speed. Oh, no destination. What? Oh, you. Oh, it's 5 million meters. Oh, what a cretin.
That's.
I'm just running that clock down, making it a bit more exciting.
Now,
I'm generally impressed with how it did stand up. The hull reinforcement packages obviously worked.
Cabin pressure alert.
I didn't have those on my previous build, and I did notice when as soon as your shields go down. With my old build, you've pretty much just got to get out there. You know what I mean? You're not in a position to take a great pounding. Don't often come up the arse end of the station. That was what that loop of shame has caused me to do.
Cabin pressure alert. Cabin pressure alert.
Yes, all right.
Alert.
There we are. Boy landing gear. Alright, let's get fixed up and get back out there. throwing caution to the wind. Okay, right, so let's see, what was that? That was, so all in all, I made about 20 grand profit on that. You right there, Pascal? Cheers for popping in, mate. That was pretty poor, but then I did decide to take on an anaconda with a wing of, with two asps, so, got two of the asps away, but the conda eluded me. Okay, let's get back on it. Okay, so we'll do another little test. If I don't target wings, I might be able to take off more than just one or two targets. We'll see. It's more of a sort of an experiment to see how it'll fare without shield cells, whether or not I really, really do need install one. Because I'd rather not, though. Well, that was quick. We're in the sun now. In that short space of time, the planet has rotated enough for us to, or at least the rings have rotated enough to be in the light, which would be fantastic because I couldn't see a single asteroid in that last encounter. Actually, no, that's a lie. It must have turned as I was in there because they started appearing when I was diving in and out of them. Right, let's try again. Take two. I don't know what about yet. Let's this guy here, what's he up to? Oh, hello. Staff Sergeant Max Flight. Okay, well let's give you a quick scan. See what goodies or what nastiness he's been up to. He needs to get on his ass a bit more, I think. This is how I tend to sort of play with the Vulture. It's very much sort of in the grill. You know, get up in their face and stuff like that, just... I haven't used fixed weapons for quite some time, so I'm going to be a little bit squiffy getting the yaw control. It's very easy to overcompensate if you haven't done it for a little while. But it's still a lovely ship that I remember it being. It's a lovely little thing. Back into his sights. Was he a dangerous one, is he? He must be distracted or something because he's not doing anything to me. Right, there you go, mate. See you later. Who else we got? Asp Scout, let's see what he's up to. Alright, so another wing. Now, what are his mates in? So, two Asp Scouts so far. If it's another Condor, I'll probably pass it up. That's this guy here. Right, what's he? We should be able to easily take out these guys then. Right. He's just in an adder, I know. It shouldn't take long, but a little bit more wily, a little bit more agile. obviously against NPCs, gimbaled weapons would probably be more efficient. However, with only the two weapons, I prefer to use fixed because they chuck chaff out. I know you can deselect them. Come on. Oh, sorry, this is terrible shooting by me. That's better. Right. Get him off our case. Also, it was a pair of adders. It was. There you go. Right. I know. Hardly something to write home about. But we'll see. This is. So this was the bring of three. Now, I'm interested to see what the third guy is flying. Got Diamondback Explorer by the looks of it. He's on his own, so let's pick him off. Expect him to quite stop so dead in the water there. So I've just got to wait for them to recharge touch. Should be good to go now if I don't miss. Hey, right.
Target destroyed.
Idiot. I'm gonna press a chaff. Right, so this again, we're still on this wing of three. Now, where's the other dude? Oh, he's over here. So, two ASP scouts, a Cobra. Right, let's give these guys a go. This will be an interesting test. So, we're gonna go 3 pips to weapons, 3 pips to systems. Awful flying there by me. Right.
Under attack.
Okay, so we'll just drop another chaff if I can. Oh no, they're reloading. I'll keep all pips into that for the sec. Okay, one down. Let's get that Cobra. He'll be the nippiest one. Maybe the bad choice. I probably should have got the ass scout, I think. Oh, I tried ramming the bastard. Right. Okay, I think we're going to need to get some space a second. See a wing, probably just a touch more off that I can chew, unfortunately, as it stands without the shield cell. I think we're gonna have to go for a bit of hide for a sec. Heatsink. get some evasive manoeuvring in. So they're just outside weapons range, which is not too bad, except for missiles. Shields are almost back up. If I can just get one of them down. If I go for the asps, because that's probably going to be the easier target. Just reduce their firepower by a touch. I might just have to go hell for leather on this. Just throw caution to the wind. Lose my shields again. Just get this guy gone. Another chaff. Alright, brilliant. That's one down. Let's get his mate. Fence pattern alpha. So we're going to be jousting each other by the looks of things here for a little bit, so hopefully I can get my shields back in touch. I've got a full capacitor's worth of weapons, so might be able to get his shields down. Oh, nope, not quite. A couple more shots. Looks like we've got him on the defensive now anyway, so should be able to turn this round. New one. Come on, mate. Let's get this in. Good volley there. Awesome. Shields are back as well. Looks like we've turned the tide on this one. Just a matter of whittling them down, isn't it? Getting that fire, reducing that firepower on you and just having that chance. Not and allowing your weapons to sort. Right, let's get stay on his tail. Oh, what an idiot! I didn't even consider that. Oh, he's gone anyway. Hey, right, all that for 28 grand. That was good. I enjoyed that. Right, we better head back 20k. Where are you? We're miles away. Alright, just keep an eye out, see if there's anything in the distance. Simon Storfus. Alright, let's. Might as well scan him. Now we're coming up behind him.
Scan detected.
Looks like his attention is elsewhere, which is awesome.
Detected. offline.
He is certainly distracted. I'm not that concerned with the peppering of small fire that he seems to be hitting me with. Wow, what a shot, that was cool. He looked like he exploded against the hull of the T9. That was awesome. You are definitely not up to no good, sir. Where are you? Almost certainly, without fail, a naughty boy. Right, good. Jonai blob. Sorry, mob. Blob. I still love these double beams. They really are. Just look at that. Totally decimated his shield. I know he's only a master. I still love the love this vulture. It's let's not stand toe to toe with him, or nose to nose, should I say? Well, that's good news, because I'm not carrying anything. You can do that if you want, mate. It's you that's got the hull issue, not me. Oh, bastard! You got shields up. Yes, all right. Thanks for the warning. Oh, there you go. See you later, dude. Been nice knowing you. Bye-bye. Whee! Right. Oh. What on earth was that? Hello, mate. Are you looking for some action? This is really intimate. Get out of my face. It's hit me with some poxy little turret. Oh, and as always, get their shields up just in the nick of time. I'll just pulse laser him. There you go. 120 grand for that. Oh my lord. Okay, let's check him out. Again, he's distracted by someone else, so we can sneak on in. Oh, looks like the T6 is fighting back. Is that a T6? Yeah, it is a little T6 fighting back gallantly. Oh, cheers for the follow, Ancient Crafter. Much appreciated, mate. Stop shooting that little T6, that poor little T6. Shoot me instead. save up some weapons charge a second. Properly unload. Right, so I'll wait until we've got a full capacitor's worth and then we'll take a check on his hull. Right, let's go. It's not bad, not bad. About 15% with one full capacitor's charge. Okay, so by the looks of it, just a couple more volleys, let it charge up. His attention is elsewhere anyway, so that's fine. Try and get both to hit. And we'll just finish him off with the remaining charge. There you go. Touché, what's he up to? Hiding behind a rock. Where'd he go? Oh, he must have just died. Right. Oh no, there he is. Let's let him know we mean business. Where have you gone? There you are. Right. Just getting both of these beams on. If I can get contact with both, it really does rip through the hulls. Oh, nippy little thing. I do miss the fun of the Corvette with trying to hit things with the PAs. Regular viewers will know that that's a fave of mine, is to try and do stupid long range shots. And more often than not, I miss. But every now and then I get a hit and it's so cool. So remember, mustn't forget, I am actually flying around asteroids, it's not a backdrop. Come on, weapons. Yay, right.
Target destroyed.
Eve Ellen White, you up to any good? I just almost completed the scan and then let go of the button. Come on, mate. Let's dance. Out of range. How many times? How many times does that happen? Get below 10% and then their shields pop back up again. It's not anymore though. Come on, mate. That's it. See you later. Imperial courier. I would imagine he's probably up to no good.
Scan detected. Under attack.
Tough old shields on these birds. Might need to have three pits to engines on this to keep him in. Keep him in my sights. Appear to be a much of an issue, so it's four pips to engine. To weapons. That's a cool ship there, isn't it? It does. It properly looks proper sci-fi. Very Star Trek sort of aesthetic to that. Far cry what it was like in the Corvette yesterday, being hounded by one of these, like a little mosquito, just kept getting in my face. I was like, fuck, go away, get off. But yeah, we were all pained to keep that. It was just so agile, getting all around me. Didn't really do a great deal of damage, took the shields down a touch, but you know, it wasn't really any threat. Obviously would have been eventually if I hadn't done anything about it. But, oh, cheers, co-pilot. Thank you. But it was just, it's just more, it's that frustration. Not frustrated with the game, but it's almost the role that it's made for, you know what I mean? To hound the larger ships. But I guess that's what this ship's for, actually, to be honest. Get him scanned as well. He wants to try and joust me, doesn't he? So let's explain to him that that's probably a bad idea. Oh, look at that hull disappear. Look, 20%. There you go. No. Don't listen to me. Right.
Target destroyed.
Okay, so about 25 minutes left. Still holding up strong. Haven't had the a lot of massive things to aim for. Back into the fray over here, I believe. Probably a little bit away from it. Let's who's those over here? Oh, another third lance. Awesome, right. Give him a chance to show us his engines. not offering much of a much opposition at the moment.
Target shields offline.
Trying to get me in his sights. He's going to get at least one pass by the looks of things. Yep. Get back around on him. That's it, right. Awesome. 187,000 credits. That is ridiculous. That circling around over there. Looks like they're cruising for a bruising. Another third lance. Closing speed was a little bit high there. Oh, so this guy's a dangerous. The last one was a master, so he didn't offer a great deal of opposition. This one's trying. We're able to match him so far, which is good. No, I still love this ship, it really is. It's as good as I remember it. As long as you take the right take on the right foe. Don't overstretch yourself. Maybe don't take on a wing of an anaconda and its two wing mates. As shown earlier. But I didn't die, managed to get out safely in that. Another 168,000, that's absolutely ridiculous. Right. Who are you? Lady Luna. Looks like he's trying to get away. Hopefully he turns and fights.
Charge detected. Scan detected.
Nice black paint job on that, I think, isn't it? Oh no, it's a standard grey one. Good dark. Still, they sound amazing. Real throaty sort of burble, like a sort of high octane, you know, high fuel rich V8 or something, just sort of burbling. Doing the same again. Closing speed's going to be absolutely. Oh, a bit of vertical thrust on that one there to miss. Got it, mate. Let's go at it. There you go. Don't go out a gunship. Look at your shields disappear. Right. As long as the majority of the armaments can't get me, that's good. Looks like he's just got turreted something or other. I can't quite place what it is. Looks like burst fragment something. I can never remember what those things are unless he's firing off chaff. That's chaff in it. Remember. Right in his grill. Right, so we'll keep four pips into our shields at the moment. Let the let them just soak up. We take off the last few percent, just wait a little bit more because of the power. Alright, now we'll just pop him off with the little bits. There you go. Right, so you can hit him with both beams. There you go.
Target destroyed.
Alright, let's get these shields charged up a touch more. Let's see what's going on over here. Alright, let's dispense some justice. Lost where they are. There they are. One percent, and boom. There he goes.
Target destroyed.
Egg Whisk. Nice name. Right. Who's down here? That's
scan detected.
Really do with these shields topping up a bit better for me. So a little asp that's causing some trouble.
Target shields online.
Power to weapons. Bites of dust.
Target destroyed.
What's going on over here? Attack pattern alpha. Oh. Oh, yeah, I suppose that'll do. Yep. Defense pattern alpha. No, it looks like this has been the spawn of asps, basically. It's been just been asp after asp after asp. Trying to say that fast. Attack pattern alpha. It's a little bit close for comfort there, mate. No, just get out of my face.
Scan detected.
Thank you.
Target destroyed.
All right, so it looks like we've got a wing of three eagles. These will be interesting. They gang up on me. Attack pattern beta. Next one.
Target shields are flying.
Next one. Attack pattern alpha. Three.
Target destroyed.
Dale Cook in a python. It would be nice to finish off on a python. I think we'll make this one the last one of this lunchtime stream, and then we'll head on back and see what we've collected. Power to weapons. Oh, that was close. That was nice. Proper little, like, turn up on his ass. There you go. Deploy heatsink. Multi-cannon turrets are peppering away, but I think I should hold out. Yeah, 2-1-0, thank you very much, sir. See you later, mate. 208,000 credits for that. Oh dear, if any of it was like that in the early days of the game. Right, I think we'll should call it there. Let's head back to Privlov. Oh, an anaconda turns up just before I leave. Right. I won't tempt fate too much though. I only got the one ring, got no shield cells or anything like that, so. Cheers. Oh. Come on, charge up. Inhibited by 23 ratio, stupid. Come on. Super handy having a port this close. Oh, trying out music. Forgot what I was doing. I didn't put it on repeat. I wonder why it was all quiet. End the stream with a bit of funk. It's like some 70s cop show where I've just been out, got all the bad guys, and now I'm rocking back into the police station. Shades on. Big flared trousers. Walking on in. I don't know. My mind works in mysterious ways. Well, it's been a really good fun re-entry back into the Vulture. It's been a good few months, easily, since I last flew it in anger or in an aggressive fashion. Yeah, it certainly was a nice little thing to try out.
Docking request granted.
We come. Okay, let's see how we've done. We haven't, again, similar to the challenge, you know, the 1 hour challenge, I haven't checked what we got. A bit better on the reload and repair this time. It was 30 grand last time, only 5 today, well, this time. Contacts on it. There you go, not bad, 1.7 million. Pretty happy with that. I wasn't obviously going hell for leather and as you say, a lot of that time I was dodging and weaving, getting my shields back up. But it's still a fantastic little ship. Can't wait to try it out in a proper timed event. But thanks for watching this afternoon. Hope you've had a good lunchtime. Hope the rest of your day isn't too bad and too boring. Some some bits and bobs to do myself, so you crack on. Nice to see you. I'll be back on tonight, 9 o'clock, GMT. Hope to see you. All right. That's on the Wednesday. I'm recording on a Wednesday, so seeing this on YouTube, probably not the case. But as always, been a pleasure. Thank you, guys. Fly safe. If you can't do that, fly dangerous. See you soon. Bye.